composite of the training centers located at Bainbridge, Maryland, San Diego, California, and Great Lakes, Illinois.
Okay, fellas. What are you trying to do? Waste the taxpayers' money? Come on, let's go.
Having left civilian life behind, the recruit finds himself in unfamiliar surroundings.
One man to each square. All right, keep moving. Take a leg then. On the double. Now put your gear down on the deck. All right, put it right there at your feet. Throw it. Now today, you men...
Now, let's see what he is governed by a new code of regulations. We're old words and phrases.
You pay for this work.
New meaning.
All right, knock off that skylarking back there. Come on up here and bring that magazine with you. What's the matter with you? Are you a baby or something? Give me that magazine. You want to get fitted like a baby or get fitted like a man? Like a man? Well, then start acting like a man. Now get back in your place and listen to what I'm going to say from now on, because what I'm going to say is important.
The men are given thorough medical and dental examinations. With equipment like this, the teeth are thoroughly checked, and where needed, complete dental care is given to each and every man. Dental and medical care that will continue for the remainder of their stay in the Navy. After this, a recruit is measured from head to toe and issued his outfit of Navy uniforms and clothing.
By now, many of you men are probably confused. I'll try to tell you what lies ahead. Today, you're being formed into Company 178. From now on, you will be part of the team, a closely knit team. Now, this is your company commander, handpicked by the Navy to mold you into qualified citizens. Before I turn you over to him, I want to impress upon you how important he'll be in your progress and welfare while you're here.
If they were never impressed with the part the company commander plays in their welfare that first day, they are in the weeks to come.
Stand up straight, Goble. Get those shoulders back. Smith, a dirty white hat. Very good, huh? You'll make good recruit petty officer material. There's Gibby, Pascal. Very good, Abel. Not too good, Stokes. You got spots on that jumper. Your neck's dirty, too. Step out here. When was the last time you took a shower? Last week. Get your gear and get in there and take a shower now.
Yes, it's up to this man to turn these 70 individuals with different backgrounds into a closely knit team. A team that will live together, eat together, study together, march together, and learn together. It's up to this company commander to mold these men into a team capable of competing as a unit against other companies. A team that, realizing the need, will develop its own leaders. To the recruit, these barracks will be his home. In addition to sleeping here, this is where he will spend a considerable portion of his time. Here he learns to live with others, to take care of himself. And if you want. And in these barracks, he learns the need for companionship, for mail from home, and for amusement and relaxation. Here he will also acquire the habit of writing letters and of budgeting his spare time.
See you later, Charlie. We've got a game in the gym with Company 128.
As the weeks pass, the recruit learns how to handle, clean, and shoot a rifle. He learns how to accept responsibility and to carry out instructions, both instantly and unhesitatingly, whether on an 80-gun crew or just blemishing a line. During this period, recruits are taught that the advancement in the Navy is through promotion, and that these promotions are generally determined by the quality of work, examination grades, and the demonstrated abilities of the individual.
You don't have to be a brain. All the Navy expects of you is to use the brain you have. Why, the average man sitting in this room right now, if he applies himself, can advance himself from the rigging hour hole up to and including the rate of chief petty officer in approximately 12 to 14 years of Navy service. In addition to the prestige and the privileges of chief petty officer, it will assure you of a much higher billfold. And men, your pay does not stop when you retire. Take myself for example. Next year, I will complete 20 years of naval service and retire. Each month thereafter, I will receive a check of $152 for the rest of my life. And then, my Navy training has prepared me for a good job in civilian life.
Through other lectures and movies similar to this one, the recruits learn something about this outfit to which they now belong.
Level your guns. Take out your top fin. And approach the head spike. Level your guns to the object. Fire!
That only by giving their all are the men of the Navy able to slash their way through the pages of history.
We have met the enemy. They are ours.
Get off the starboard tower, sir!
Unbelievable as it sometimes seems, it was through the heroic and gallant actions of these men that our country and our Navy survived.
Don't give up the ship.
The discipline, the training, and the obedience to orders had paid off. Whether aboard the USS Guerriere in the choppy Bay of Algiers, or behind guns booming in the South Pacific in World War II, or even more recently, off Korea, it was the men that made the United States Navy what it is today.
Here they come!
Volunteer for special duty. As well as fireman assignments. The Navy explains to them how they, with a proper qualification, may become eligible for orders to study at the Naval Academy Preparatory School to prepare them for an appointment to the Naval Academy in Annapolis, Maryland, or to qualify for one of the many other programs available to them to advance from seaman to admiral. Make sure that every recruit spends some time acquiring the proper appreciation for the routine and practical side of life aboard ship. While in the advanced stages of his training, the center prepares him for every emergency, from fighting fires, the dread of seamen at sea, to saving the life of his shipmate, or his very own. Although the men have rather full schedules, there is always time for relaxation, and they soon discover that the training center has facilities for just about everything, from playing ball and building models to catching up on the latest books and dance steps with friends they have met since they've been in the service. On weekends, when not on liberty or on watch, the men are encouraged to have visitors and to acquaint their guests firsthand with the training center. In addition to a full religious program, the Navy conducts a special character guidance program. Taking over where the family left off, this program develops to the fullest the moral concepts common to all faiths.
Oh,
see that each man is assigned to the right job upon completion of recruit training, teams of highly qualified classification personnel screen everyone thoroughly. Through a series of tests, the man's general educational aptitudes, his mechanical, and his mathematical aptitudes are brought to light. By careful interview, the Navy discovers his personal desires. With all these factors known, finding the spot into which the recruit will readily and easily fit in the best interest of the Navy is relatively simple, since there are more than 60 different technical ratings and job specialties for any man qualified. Out of the 75 men who started in this company which you see graduating today, 27 of them will leave directly for service and job training in the fleet. 7 others will be assigned to various shore stations, such as airfields or naval operating bases. 38 of the company will be assigned to technical schools, located at one of the 3 training centers or at other shore installations. Here they will join others returning from the fleet under orders to be trained in a wide variety of technical skills, leading to greater responsibility in the Navy. At some of these schools, the men will study to become electronics technicians, journalists, fire controllers, and machinists. In other schools, the men will be required to master such fields as communications, the clerical duties of yeomen, guided missiles, or the operation of the boilers and machinery to be found in the engine room of a ship. Some learn to care for the teeth and the human body. Others concentrate on taking care of the miles of involved piping systems found in the bowels of fighting ships. To keep our Navy the best fed Navy in the world, there are special schools to train commissary men, butchers and stewards. At some of the training centers, the men will study in new buildings. At others, much older ones. But whether new buildings are old, all schools employ the latest training aids, devices, and educational techniques.
Company honor man for Company 124. Is Seaman Recruit Jerry Sandler, Biloxi, Mississippi.
Company so, as the men in the graduating companies look forward with anticipation to their future assignments, the graduation review draws to a close with the awarding of certificates to the company honor men and the presentation of the American Spirit Medal.
A man who, in the opinion of his officers and shipmates, has displayed the outstanding qualities of leadership best expressing the American spirit, honor, initiative, loyalty, and a high example to comrades in arms. It's our extreme pleasure to present this medallion to Thomas Dixon Greer, Felton, Delaware. Chaplain Goodman will now give the benediction.
Let us pray. Almighty God, eternal Father, we earnestly pray that thou wilt receive into thy protection and care these men who are about to go forth to defend justice and freedom. Grant that the discipline and training they have received here may fit them to serve their country worthily. loyalty to their loved ones at home, but they, in return, may know the joy of faithful love. Teach them to serve thee, O Lord, and to honor their shipmates. Teach them also to give and not to count the cost, to fight and not to ease the wound, to work and not to seek reward. And always keep alive in their hearts an adventurous spirit to make them worthy of the courageous souls who in every age have ventured on in obedience to thy call and the call of conquering. This we ask of you, dear God. Amen. And then? As they pass this reviewing stand, the hardening up process will be behind them. And before them, opportunities unlimited.
Johnson, and this is one of the most unusual days of my life.
Forward! Far!
I can't describe my feelings exactly. Usually I tear into those ham and eggs, but today my stomach feels tense. It's a new kind of tension for me. How can I explain it? I had that fellow's duty during my service week. So let's see, he's in training about 5 weeks behind me. Those guys have just got their full clothing issue. That would make them 4 weeks behind me. Funny, everything I've been through so far, some other recruit will be going through for the first time today. Some civilians are probably just arriving at the airport. The whole thing ahead of them. You know, it's all happening for somebody. The whole 9 weeks of boot camp, right here today.
Remember, do not leave that area at any time. Do not harass any civilian dudes. Do not fight or argue amongst yourselves. Do not whistle or make catcalls at any ladies that might pass by. Keep in mind at all times, even though you are not in uniform, you are members of the armed forces, subject to these rules and regulations. Are there any questions? You all understand? Group leader, take charge of your men and go out that door and turn left.
Call home to your parents. No matter what time it is in your locality, I want you to call. call and tell your folks that you have arrived safely.
Go down there. Go down there. Clear it out. Right close in front of the sheriff. Thank you, sir. What part of Texas are you from?
Kid, give me your card. Size shoes you usually wear.
Thanks.
Put your foot in there. How's that feel?
A little small.
Okay, take it off. Okay, put your foot in there. That feel a little better?
Yes, sir.
Okay, take it off.
Any of you people who cannot pass the swim test will be giving expert instruction. We got the best swimming instructors in the world here, so you don't have to worry about drowning.
You will answer up, so I know you're out here. You'll answer up loud and clear. Is that understood?
Yes, sir.
Bode, Roland, 10.
Yes.
Borger, Thomas, 11. Brayley, Randall, 12. Brower, Ray, 13. Brown, Con, 14. Browning, Ray, 15. Duhane, Carlos, 16.
Today, some of the new recruits will have finished the check-in routine, and their company will be formally...
have people in charge. Apodaca, you're going to be in charge of the group that goes to Galley 8.
Put your hand on the canister. Breathe in.
If you get a good tight fit, you know it's fit your face properly, and it's going to give you confidence in that mask. But it's not going to leak or let you down. Now let's put it on.
Your fifth general order, people.
Getting there when they issued the full uniform.
Get with it.
Today I put mine on with extra special care. This is one inspection I'm going to pass with flying colors. Thinking back, the week that made me feel I was finally arriving was Fleet Week. And the most fun was the final sports weekend. The competition between the companies was terrific. It was a great time. The day that really has me stirred up is today. Because, man, this is it for me. Graduation day.
Hey, I'm going to go down to the zoo, man.
You guys got overnight?
What are you going to the zoo for?
Hey, the zoo. Have you seen it?
No.
The place is big.
My parents and even my girlfriend, along with many others, have come up here for the big ceremony. The tension's been building up in me all day. Now, at last...
Company, at ease. Okay, man.
This is what we've worked for 9 weeks. Graduation day. You guys know the hard, back-breaking work we've put in for this day. Your families, your wives, your girlfriends are going to be out there. Let's make it the best one of all, huh?
Some of the guys will be going on to A schools. Some will stay here for apprentice training. Anyway, we're Navy men now.
Hey, here
he is. Oh, it's been so long. You look wonderful.
Hey, how you doing?
Pretty good, sir.
Sir? Did you hear him say sir? He didn't call me sir all his life. Good to see you.
Now I know what it is I've been trying to say. Boot camp showed me that any man who tries can measure up and gain a new awareness of his own ability. It's a feeling of accomplishment.